Hello, Gnattersdoms. Explaining science by debunking idiots saying stupid shit on the internet is fun and all, but sometimes it's good to take a step back, ignore the stupid, and enjoy the science on its own. So today, I'm going to show you how to extract your own DNA using stuff you probably already have lying around. You'll need 2 glasses, a teaspoon, water, baking powder or bicarbonate, salt, dish soap, denaturated alcohol, a freezer, and a mouth to get DNA from. Step 1. Put the denatured alcohol in the freezer. We need it to be nice and chilly for later. Step 2. The boring part, waiting for the alcohol to cool down. There's a lot of waiting in science. Step 3. The not boring part of science. Take one of the 2 glasses and 1 to 2 deciliters of water and put the latter in the former. Next, get your spoon out. Add 1 teaspoon of baking powder and a pinch of salt to your glass of water and stir. The reason for doing this is that your body isn't full of tap water. The water in it is slightly salty and slightly alkaline, so we want to emulate that to keep the cheek cells we are about to extract alive. No point in killing them before we want to kill them. Also, the salt will help us make the DNA visible later on. Step 4. Getting some DNA out of you or your volunteer. Or rather, some of your cells. Getting the DNA out comes later. Now, take a big gulp of the salty baking powder water and start swishing it around your mouth for 30 to 40 seconds. Also, scrape the inside of your cheeks with your teeth. That way you will get more of your cells out. Oh, and don't swallow the water. It won't harm you, but the baking powder will react with your stomach acid, produce CO2, and give you a slight case of the burps. Plus, you need it to do the rest of the experiment. Once the time is up, spit it out into the other glass. Step 5. If all has gone as planned, you should now have a glass of water with a bunch of your cells floating around in it. In fact, there's probably several thousands of them. Each of them have about 2 meters of DNA locked away inside their nuclei in 46 pieces of varying sizes. We need to get that out. The cell membrane and the membrane surrounding the nucleus are both made of fat, specifically phospholipids. You can think of cells as little fat bubbles with smaller fat bubbles inside them. The trick to get the DNA out is to break the bubbles, and for that, you need soap. So, add a couple of drops of dish soap to the mix and stir gently a couple of times. We aren't trying to make foam, you just want the soap to dissolve. Step 6. Okay, last step. You technically don't need to do it. If you look closely, you should already be able to see the DNA. And if you wait a bit, it should become more visible. But fuck that, we're lazy. The solution is to not make a solution. Trust me, that will make sense in a moment. For now, go get your alcohol out of the freezer. Very carefully pour it into the glass. Thanks to the temperature difference, you can keep the water and alcohol from mixing. If done right, it should end up on top of the water in its own face. In no time, you should start to see an odd white, snotty candy flush blob rise from the water and into the spirits, like the ghost of a jellyfish. That is your DNA. So, what's going on here? Why can we see the DNA now? Why is it rising into the alcohol phase? And how did all that fit into the tiny cells? Well, last question first. It's a matter of organization. The DNA inside the nucleus of a living cell is very well organized, and the cell spends tons of energy keeping it that way. The DNA is compacted, the strands are wound up around proteins called histones, and the parts not being used are wound up even more. Once the cell dies, all of this stops, and like a pair of headphones in your pocket, the strands become a mess. Except in this case, it's not just one pair, but hundreds of thousands getting entangled with each other. That's also part of why we can see it. It's simply taking up more space. The other reason has to do with the chemistry of DNA. If you look at the chemical structure of it, you'll see that it's made of base pairs connected to a sugar phosphate backbone. And you will see that the phosphates are negatively charged. That's important, because that's the reason why DNA is solvable in water. Water is polar, that is, some parts of a water molecule are slightly negative, while others are slightly positive. The negatively charged DNA is attracted to the positive parts of the water, which keeps it dissolved. The same thing is happening with the positively charged sodium ions from the salt we added and the negative parts of the water. The DNA and the sodium ions are also attracted to each other, but the polar water molecules keeps them from interacting a whole lot. Ethanol is also polar, but not as much as water. When you add it, the sodium ions are able to bind to the DNA's phosphates, which results in a compound without any charges, since the plus and minus cancel out. This salted DNA, to use a very non-technical term, is no longer solvable. So, it precipitates and clumps together into snot blobs. And there you have it. DIY DNA extraction. Hope you enjoyed this departure from my usual videos. I might do more like it. Oh, and feel free to send your results on Twitter if you decide to try it out yourself.